Hi there, and thanks for joining me today. In this miniature world in which we find ourselves, the houses are constructed with all of their proportions 12 times smaller than usual. That can be written as a ratio, as 1 to 12. A 1 centimeter item here would become 12 centimeters in the real world. A ratio is a relation between two numbers. The ancient Greeks called ratios logos, which had a few meanings, including word and reason. When Greek mathematical texts were translated into Latin, the word ratio was used. In Latin, ratio meant something that was reasoned out, calculated, or thought through. Our good friend pi is a ratio, the ratio of a circle's circumference to its diameter. Pi cannot be expressed as the ratio of two integers, and so it is called irrational. Isn't it funny that a ratio is also irrational? How can that be? Well, circumference and diameter are not necessarily integers. In fact, it will always be the case here that if the diameter is an integer, the circumference is not an integer. And if the circumference is an integer, the diameter is not an integer, precisely because pi is irrational. The diagonal of any square can be found by Pythagoras, and using a square with side length 1, we can see that the ratio from the side to the diagonal will always be 1 to the square root of 2. The square root of 2 is another irrational number. It is rumoured that the Greek Hippasus, who first discovered the existence of irrational numbers, was drowned at sea by his fellow Pythagoreans as they found his work too shocking to accept. Here we have a circle inside of a square. As a little challenge, let's try to find the ratio of the area of the circle to the area of the square. To find the area of the circle, we would use pi r squared, where r is the radius. And since there are 2 radii in a side, we could square a side and get 4r squared as the area of the square. Cancel the r squareds and you get that the ratio of the circle's area to the square's area is pi to 4. This is always true for a circle inscribed in a square. And so that's been our little look at ratios. Thanks for watching.